Hello students, welcome you all in my lecture series, and today I'm going to discuss about the truss. So truss, you all know that this is a basic structure and it is used in the many kind of bridge and many kind of the structures where huge load is applied. So to distribute the load in the different direction, we use truss. So we'll go in the detail. So first of all, let's discuss about what is the meaning of the word truss so that we can understand it in deep. So truss is made of two words. First one is triangular and second one is the cylinder. Triangular means any triangular structure like this, geometrical triangular structure. So new word is here, cylinder. So what is cylinder? So let's talk about these two cylindrical object. So what's the basic difference between these two object? If we'll see, then this is the length of this cylinder and this is the dia of this cylinder. Again, similarly, this is the length of this another cylinder and this is the dia. So in this case, this diameter with respect to this length is not very small, but in this case, in the case of the second cylinder, this diameter is very, very, very less than this length. So what will be the effect when we'll apply load on these two cylinders? So first, when we'll apply the load on this cylinder, and suppose this load W is passing through the centroidal axis. Okay. So in this case, it is not going to produce any moment about the centroidal axis. All load will pass directly from top point to the bottom point axially. So in the second case, if we shift the load away from the centroidal axis, suppose from here, W. So this W is going to create one moment and its value will be, as we know, force into perpendicular distance, W into D. So since the diameter is not less, so moment has certain value. But in this second case, since the diameter is very, very less with respect to length, so if we'll find the moment, suppose load is applied at the end of this cylinder, so moment will be W into D. So in this case, since the diameter is very less, the value of moment will be not remarkable. So we can say that in the second case, whatever load will be applied at the top, that will pass directly from the centroidal axis towards the bottom direction. Even if you apply the load at the end, we can treat that load also as a axial load because the value of moment is very less. So this is the meaning of cylinder. Means on the cylindrical object, whatever load we'll apply, that load will pass axially towards the bottom. It is not going to create any eccentric effect or any moment. So that's the meaning of cylinder. So here we are talking about the triangular cylinder. It means there will be three cylinder and that will be connected so that it will form one triangular shape. So this is your basic structure of truss. We can draw the truss here. Just the basic structure. This triangle is your truss. And we know that in the geometry, this triangle is the most stable structure. That's why we have chosen such kind of structure, such kind of basic structure for the truss. So for this truss, there are three members, member one, member two, member three. You can write also like A, B, C. So three members, first member AB, second member AC, and third member BC. And these three members are the cylinder. It means whatever load we'll apply, that load will axially transmit through this cylinder object. So now, when we go in the detail, we'll find that in the truss, these three cylindrical objects are connected at three joints, joint A, joint B, and joint C. There are three joints. So all the three joints are connected by the pin joint. So now what is pin joint? So let's discuss about the pin joint little bit so that we will be able to understand that why we are giving the pin joint here, here and here. So when we'll think about the basic pin joint, then take like this is your rod and which is connected here at point O by a pin joint. Then how to draw the free body diagram of this pin joint? When we think about the pin joint at point O, this is also called hinge joint, then we can rotate this rod like this. In this plane, we can rotate it, right? We all know that if there is a pin joint, we can rotate it. We can take the example of door. There is a pin joint so that we can rotate the door about a vertical line because there is a pin joint. If that will be a fixed joint, then door will never be rotated. So that is the advantage of pin joint. Pin joint never restrict the rotational motion. So we can rotate this rod about this plane. So now when we will draw the free body diagram over here at point O, now we can say that we can't move this rod in the x direction. Because when we'll try to move it in x direction, then this joint will apply force in the reverse direction, reactive force. So we can say that there is one force, that is Rx here. Since this rod is not able to move in the x direction, so it means this joint is applying one force in the reverse direction, in the backward direction, that is Rx. Similarly, if we'll try to move this rod in the vertical y direction, this is also not possible because this joint is again going to create one reverse force. So the value of that reverse force is Ry. And this is the free body diagram of any of the pin joint. So we can say that pin joint in a plane restricts two motion, two translational motion, but it never restricts the rotational motion. So there will be no moment here, because meaning of moment means if you are applying any reactive moment here, it means that moment will stop the rotation of this rod. But since this rod is able to rotate, it means this joint is not applying any moment in the reverse direction. So this is the free body diagram of pin joint. So from this diagram, it is clear that all these pin joint will only restrict the translational motion in x and y direction. It will not restrict the rotational motion. So now it's clear here. So we have applied three pin joint. Now, I don't think this structure is complete till now. We have to add some more things to make it a complete frame. What is the meaning of frame? Now this structure is not complete. It means there is some deficiency. Now we have to check what is the deficiency in this small structure. That I'm going to discuss here. So what is the deficiency of this structure? So we know that if any object is kept in a plane, in an xy plane, any object is kept in an xy plane, then how much degree of freedom that object has? So we can say that if it is kept in a plane, it can be translated in the x direction, it can be translated in the y direction. It means there are two translational motion, so 2 degrees of freedom. And third is the rotation about a plane. So one rotation and 2 translational motion, so total degree of freedom is 3. For any object kept in a single plane has total degree of freedom 3. Right? So here this object has degree of freedom equal to 3. 2 translational motion and 1 rotational motion, so total 3 degrees of freedom. So here there are 3 rods, 1, 2, 3. 3 members, 3 rods. So how many degrees of freedom should be there? For each object, since we are talking about the truss in a plane, so each member has 3 degrees of freedom, 2 translational, 1 rotation. So for the member 1, there is a 3 degrees of freedom. For member 2, again 3 degrees of freedom. And member 3, again there is 3 degrees of freedom. Total degree of freedom is going to be 9 here. So we have to restrict the 9 degrees of freedom if you want to make a stable structure. So that's my target. How to fix this 9 degrees of freedom. So now let's see. One pin joint means 2 degrees of freedom has already been arrested, right? So 2 degrees of freedom is arrested here, 2 degrees freedom is arrested here, and last 2 degrees freedom is arrested here. So total 6 degrees of freedom is already locked here. I already told, let me repeat here because it will be going to be very complicated here. One member, 3 degrees of freedom in a single plane. Second member, again 3 degrees of freedom. Third member, again 3 degrees of freedom. Total degree of freedom is 9. If you want to restrict this object, we want to make this object very stable, then we have to stop the 9 degrees of freedom. We have to lock the 9 degrees of freedom. How to lock it? So we have made 3 joints, joint 1, joint 2, and joint 3. And each joint restricts 2 degrees of freedom. So total here, 2, 2, and 2. Total 6 degrees of freedom is already locked. Locked or arrested. Matlab, how much degree of freedom is left now? Only 3. So we have to restrict 3 degrees of freedom. Now what I'm going to do here, first we'll make one and fixed joint, another roller joint. This is the fixed support and the roller support. We are going to apply two kind of support here, fixed support and the roller support. So before going into detail, we need to know what is the meaning of this fixed support and what is the meaning of this roller support. So let me go in the detail of these two supports, so how these supports is going to help us to make this triangular structure very stable. So let's discuss about that. So now, fixed support, what is the meaning of fixed support? That we need to discuss here. So suppose this is the fixed support. See, no pin joint, this is completely fixed. What is the meaning of that? If we'll fix anything, suppose this object is fixed here, like this, okay? Now, if we'll try to move in the X direction, it's not possible because it's fixed here. You can't move it in the Y direction because it is fixed here. Even we can't rotate it. It's not possible. If it is fixed it completely, anything if it is fixed completely, it's not possible to rotate it also. So it means here rotation is not possible because it's fixed. Translation is not possible. We can't move it in X direction. It means this fixed support is applying in one force in the X direction. If Rx will be 0, then only it can be rotated, it can be shifted in the X direction. But since support is applying one force Rx in the reverse direction, so it's not possible to move it in the X direction. Similarly, you can't move it in the Y direction because another force Ry is acting here. We also can't rotate it because this is fixed. If you try to rotate it, suppose we try to rotate in the reverse direction, anti-clockwise direction. Now this support will apply the same moment in the reverse direction. So this is the free body diagram of fixed support. So what's the difference in the free body diagram of a hinge support and the fixed support? Only one thing is there. Two reactive force and one extra moment is coming here. In the hinge support, this moment was missing. But in the fixed support, there is one moment that support is going to apply on the object. So this is the free body diagram of the fixed support. Now talk about the roller support here. This is your roller support. So what is the meaning of roller support? See, this is your roller support. So now, this roller support means there is one small cylindrical object here. If you try to move this object in the X direction, we know that rolling friction has the minimum value. So we can easily shift this rod in the X direction because there is one roller. Roller will never restrict the motion in the X direction. By rotation, it will allow the translation in the X direction. It means the roller support will never restrict the motion in the X direction. But when we'll try to move this object in the Y direction, this roller is going to apply one force in the reverse direction, Ry. So we can say that one roller support can apply force only in the vertical direction, not in the horizontal direction. So this is the free body diagram of a roller support. So now, we'll try to draw the free body diagram over here. One fixed support means one Rx1, Ry1. One roller support, Ry2. So now we can say that 2 + 2 + 2, total 6. 2 degrees of freedom is locked here. 6 + 2 = 8. 1 degree of freedom is locked here. 8 + 1 = 9. It means all 9 degrees of freedom has already been arrested here. So now this structure becomes stable. It can't be moved. It can't be rotated. So this smallest stable structure is called truss. So a minimum truss has 3 joints. 1, 2, 3. One fixed support and one roller support. A net degree of freedom must be 0. Then this is a perfect truss, and this is the most perfect truss if you'll think about the minimum truss. So next topic we'll discuss in the next lecture. Thank you.